Welcome to Vani Current Affairs. The World Meteorological Day observed on 23rd March. World Meteorological Day is observed on every year, 23rd March, to highlight the importance of the role that people and their behavior play in protecting Earth's atmosphere. The theme of World Meteorological Day 2021 is the ocean, our climate and weather. Government launches Gram Ujwala scheme to offer LED bulbs in rural areas. The Government of India has launched an ambitious scheme called Gram Ujwala, under which high quality energy efficient LED bulbs will be given for just rupees 10 per piece in rural areas. This scheme is in the line with the government's climate change strategy and further strengthening its self-reliance credentials. The Gram Ujwala program was launched by Power and New and Renewable Energy Minister R.K. Singh in Bihar. Bihar is the first state to have ethanol promotion policy. Bihar has become the first state of the country to have its own ethanol policy called Ethanol Production Promotion Policy 2021. The policy was approved by central government in December 2020 in consonance with National Policy of Biofuels 2018 and subsequently by a National Bio Coordination Committee. Center report more than 57,000 lakh rupees disbursed under Atal Pension Yojana till February 2021. The government has said that more than 57,000 lakh rupees have been disbursed under Atal Pension Yojana till January this year. Till February this year. Minister of State for Finance and Corporate Affairs, Anurag Singh Thakur, mentioned this in a written reply to a question in Lok Sabha. He said the Atal Pension Yojana is a government scheme launched on 9th May 2015 and become operational with effect from 1st of June 2015. He said it is open to all the citizens of India between 18 to 40 years of age, having a saving bank account in a bank or post office. More than 23 lakh loan sanctioned to beneficiaries under Prime Minister Swanidhi scheme. The government has said that more than 23 lakh loans have been sanctioned to the beneficiaries under the Pradhan Mantri Street Vendor Atmanirbhar Swanidhi scheme. Minister of State for Finance Anurag Thakur said this is a written reply to a question in Lok Sabha. He said over 18 lakh loans have been disbursed to the beneficiaries. The PM Swanidhi scheme has launched on 1st of June 2020 with the objective to facilitate collateral free working capital loan up to 10,000 rupees to 50 lakh street vendors across the country whose business had been adversely affected due to lockdown. The 67 National Film Awards announced. The winner of the 67 National Filmfare Award was announced on 22 March 2021 in New Delhi to honor the best of India's cinema in 2019. The Most Film-Friendly State Award Sikkim Award for the Best Book on Cinema, A Gandhian Affair, The Indian Curious Portrayal of Love in Cinema by Sanjay Suri, Best Feature Film, Marakkar, Lion of the Arabian Sea in Malayalam. Best Actor shared Manoj Vajpayee for Bhosle and Dhanush for Asuran Tamil. Best Actress Kangana Ranaut for Panga and Manikarnika, the Queen of Jhansi. The Best Director Sanjay Puran Singh Chauhan for Bhattar Hurayan. Best Non-Feature Film, An Engineer Dream. Best Hindi Film, Chichore. Indian Navy undertook passage exercise with Royal Bahrain Naval Force. The Indian Navy undertook passage exercise PASEX with Royal Bahrain Naval Force corveted Al Muharraq in Persian Gulf under Operation Sankalp. The PASEX were conducted regularly by Indian Navy with units of friendly foreign navies while visiting each other ports or during a rendezvous at sea. It is mainly for to enhance interoperability and strengthening the bilateral maritime cooperation, reassuming diaspora and merchant shipping. The INS Talwar mission deployed for Operation Sankalp. Global Home Price Index Q4 2020. The Turkey tops and India plays last at 56th rank. India has gone down 13 spots to rank at 56th place in latest Global Home Price Index 2020 released by property consultant Knight Frank. India reported a decline of 3.6% year on year in home prices to finish last in the fourth and the last quarter ending December 2020. In Q4 2019, it ranked 43rd in the same quarter. Turkey was the leading country in the global ranking with home prices up by 30.3% year on year, followed by New Zealand at 18.6% year on year and Slovakia at 16%. Vice President of India launches Bringing Governments and People Closer. On 20th March 2021, Honorable Vice President of India, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu, launches the book Bringing Governments and People Closer. A development practitioner's prescription was launched through virtual mode. The book was authored by Dr. M. Ramachandran, IAS retired. Sports Minister decides to extend Khelo India scheme from 2021-22 to 25-26. The Sports Ministry has decided to extend the Khelo India scheme for a period of 5 years from 21-22 to 25-26. The amount of 8,750 crores was estimated the financial implication of new Khelo India schemes by the Expenditure Finance Committee. An amount of rupees 657.71 crore has been allocated to the budget estimated for the financial year 21-22 under Khelo India scheme. In addition to rupees 13.73 crore had been released till then for the promotion of the sports among disabled sports under one vertical of the Khelo India scheme, namely promotion of the sports among persons with disabilities. The Road Safety World Series T20 India Legends beat Sri Lanka Legends to win 2021. On March 21, 2021, India's Legend defeated Sri Lanka Legends by 14 runs in the final Road Safety World Series to clinch the title. It was held at Shahid Veer Narayan Singh International Stadium in Raipur, Chhattisgarh. India Legends put on a huge total of 181 for four from their allotted 20 overs. Sachin Tendulkar, captain of the team Legends, finished the tournament as the third highest run getter with 233 runs from 7 matches. Player of the match, Yusuf Pathan, India Legends. Most run, Tilaka Ratna Dilsan. Most wickets, Tilak Ratna Dilsan. Player of the series, Tilak Ratna Dilsan from Sri Lanka Legends. Nojomi Okuhara clinches women title. Malaysia's Lee Jijiang wins All England Badminton Championship men's title. In badminton, Malaysia's Lee Jijiang has won the All England Badminton Championship men's title as it defeated Denmark's Victor Axelsen in the summit class. The 22-year-old defeated Alexson 30-23, 20-22, 21-19 set class. He is the first Malaysian to win the All England Open since Lee Chong Wai in 2017. Japan's Nojomi Okuhara won the women's single title after she defeated Thailand's Pon Parvi Chongwong in 21-12, 21-16 in the final to win All England Badminton Championship 2021. World Tuberculosis Day observed on March 24. The World Tuberculosis Day observed on March 24 each year is designed to build public awareness about the global pandemic of tuberculosis and efforts to eliminate the disease. The theme for the World TB Day 2021 is "The Clock is Ticking," which conveys the sense that the world is running out of time to act on the commitments to end the deadly disease made by the global leaders. In 2018, 10 million people fell ill with TB and 5 million died from the disease, mostly in low and middle income countries. The INS Jalashwa with 1,000 metric ton rice, 1 lakh hydrochloroquinine tablet reached Madagascar's port Ehola. As part of Mission Sagar 4, Indian naval ship Jaleshwar reached at Port Aloha, Madagascar to deliver a consignment of 1,000 metric ton of rice and 1 lakh hydrochloroquinine tablet in response to an appeal made by Madagascar for assistance to deal with natural calamities. U.S. Senate confirms India-American Dr. Vivek Murthy as President Biden's Surgeon General. The U.S. Senate has voted to confirm India's American Dr. Vivek Murthy to be President Biden's Surgeon General, handing the administration one of the top public health officials amid the coronavirus pandemic. The senators voted with 54-43 to confirm the India's American as Biden's Surgeon General. Dr. Murthy mentioned he is deeply grateful to be confirmed by the Senate to serve once again and as the Surgeon General. Jal Jeevan Mission, Andaman and Nicobar achieved 100% functional household tap connection coverage. Andaman and Nicobar Island Governor Admiral D.K. Joshi declared that the Union Territory achieved 100% functional household tap connection coverage in the island. He said that in a function at Rajnivas in Port Blair on World Water Day. With this, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands becomes the third state union territory in the country to achieve the target after Goa and Telangana under Jal Jeevan Mission. The Nagaland Health Minister launches iLearn. Nagaland Health and Family Welfare Minister S. Pungyu Form launches iLearn, a capacity building and performance tracking application for community health officers. The CHOs in the state at his office chamber. The state government launched an iLearn application in the partnership with USAID, NISTA, PIGO, which will cater across the 189 health and wellness centers in the state. The Fitch rating estimates India's growth to 12.8% for next fiscal year. American credit rating agency Fitch has revised India's GDP growth estimate to 8% for the next fiscal year from the previous 11% on the back of the stronger carryover effect, a looser fiscal stance, and a better virus containment. The rating agency is the latest global economic outlook GEO anticipates the level of the country's GDP to remain well below its pre-pandemic forecast trajectory. The Fitch also expects GDP growth to ease to 8% in the fiscal year 2023. ICICI Bank initiates instant EMI facility on net banking for high value transactions. Private sector lender ICICI Bank has launched an instant EMI facility on its internet banking platform called EMI@internetbanking. The facility would allow pre-approved customers to convert high value transaction up to rupees 5 lakh into ease monthly installment EMIs. ICICI Bank is the present day introduced to launch of an instant EMI facility on its web banking platform. the RBI to examine a proposal to merge two or more urban cooperative banks as per the amalgamation of the urban cooperative banks directions 2020 issued by the RBI, it may consider proposals for merger and amalgamation among UCBs under three circumstances, including when the net worth of the amalgamated bank is positive and amalgamating banks assures to protect entire deposits. The RBI set up a panel to examine applications for banks. SFBs, the Reserve Bank of India, has set up a 5-member standing external advisory committee for the purpose of evaluating applications for universal banks as well as small finance banks. The panel will be headed by the former RBI Deputy Governor Shyamal Gopinath, and the other members are Revati Iyer, Director Central Board, Reserve Bank of India; B. Mohapatra, former Executive Director, RBI and presently Chairman of National Payments Corporation of India; T. N. Manoharan, former Chairman, Canara Bank; and Heman G. Contractor, former MD, State Bank of India, and former Chairman, Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority. The tenure of this SCAC will be of 3 years. In November 2020, the RBI made public a working group report that recommended that well-run large non-banking financial companies with an asset size of rupees 50,000 crore and above, including those which are owned by a corporate bank, a corporate house, should be considered for conversion into banks. ESAF Small Finance Bank bags Great Place to Work Award. The ESAF Small Finance Bank has been awarded Great Place to Work certification by Great Place to Work Institute. The ESAF started its operation as an NGO in 1992 as Evangelical Social Action Forum. Before becoming the bank, ESAF has a non-banking finance company and microfinance institute licensed by the Reserve Bank of India and headquartered in Thrissur, city of Kerala. Government exits from TCL nets ₹8,846 crore. On March 22, 2021, the government has fully exited Tata Communication Limited by selling its 12% stake and has netted ₹8,846 crore in the process. The Department of Investment and Public Asset Management, disinvestment of government holding completed of 12% in TCL throughout OFS at ₹5,457 crore and 10% to strategic partners at OFS discovered price for ₹3,389 crore. In the strongest armed forces, India ranked fourth and China tops, the military's direct study. China has the longest military force in the world, while India stands at number four, according to a study titled Ultimate Military Strength Index, released by defense website Military Direct. The China has the strongest military in the world, scoring 82 out of 100 points in the index. For ICC Women's World Cup 2022, Girl Gang announced official song. The Girl Gang, a track by New Zealand singer Jin Wingmore, has been announced as the official song of 2022 ICC Women's World Cup. The tournament is set to be hosted in New Zealand from March 4 to April 3, 2022. Originally, it was scheduled to be held from February 6 to March 7, 2021. The World Cup was postponed by the year due to COVID-19 pandemic. The International Cricket Council made the announcement in an event at Mugundai Beach. Education Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank and Director General of UNESCO holds virtual meeting. The Education Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank held a virtual meeting with Director General of UNESCO, Ms. Andre Ojole, in New Delhi. They discussed key issues of mutual importance, including national education policy, India's response to COVID-19 pandemic, especially in the education sector. Mr. Pokhriyal said the government has ensured that education reaches even the last child in the remotest part of country. He also spoke about the Mano Darpan, the government's initiative to provide online psychosocial support to students, teachers and families for their mental health and emotional well-being. More than 68,33,000 beneficiaries benefited maternity benefits in 2022. More than 68,33,000 beneficiaries were provided maternity benefits in 2020 under the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. The Women and Child Development Minister Smriti Irani said this is in a written reply in Rajya Sabha. The government implements the schemes with the objectives of providing partial compensation for the wage loss in terms of cash incentives so that the woman can take adequate rest before and after delivery of the first child. Under the scheme, the government also provides cash incentive to improve health seeking behavior amongst the pregnant woman and lactating mothers. Pradhan Mantri Matri Vandana Yojana, Andhra Pradesh CM unveiled Kurnool Airport. The Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy has inaugurated the Kurnool Airport located at Orvakal and named it after the first ever freedom fighter of the country, Yuval Lavada Narasimha Reddy, as a tribute to him. While addressing the gathering at Kurnool, the CM has said that the flight operation from the airport will commence from March 28. Servicing to Bangalore, Visakhapatnam and Chennai routes. Bihar 10 crore Ayushman card handed over to the beneficiary. Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana has registered a landmark achievement with the issuing of 10 crore cards to a resident of Bihar. A 25-year-old Irfan Ali from Gopalganj district had received this card. This landmark achievement is a result of Aapke Dwar Ayushman campaign, which was launched to spread awareness among the beneficiaries. Under the scheme, any family can avail free medical benefits up to 5 lakh rupees per year. Harsha Mariwala honored as EY Entrepreneur of the Year 2020. The Harsha C. Mariwala, Chairman of Marico, was named the Entrepreneur Year of 2020. He will now represent India at the EY World Entrepreneur of the Year Award. Andhra Gov Lauds DGP Sawang confirmed for Scotch Award. The Governor Vishwabhushan Harichandan has commented DGP Gautam Sawang for receiving the Scotch Award as the best DGP in the country for outstanding performance in policing public safety and taking up technical reforms in Andhra Pradesh Police. The DGP called on the governor at the Raj Bhavan. Krishnan also praised the DGP and his team for winning the FICCI Best State Award for Smart Innovative Policing and for being adjudged as the best in the country for connecting with the interoperable criminal justice system of National Crime Record Bureau. Nomadland bags top award at 2021. The Producer Guild Award, Cleo Jahao's Nomadland received a major boost ahead of Oscar as the movie bagged the top prize at 2021 Producer Guild Award. The winner for the award were announced during a vital ceremony. Nomadland, a forerunner for the Best Picture Oscar, took home the trophy for Daryl F. Janook Award for Outstanding Producer of Theatrical Motion Picture. GIP is India's ranked 40th on International Intellectual Property Index. India ranked 40 among 53 global economies on the latest annual edition of the International Intellectual Property Index. India ranked 40th in 2020 also scoring 38.4 out of 100 on a set of 50 intellectual property related indicators. The United States, Japan, and Europe remained at the top of the global intellectual property ranking 2021. While emerging markets such as the UAE, China, and Mexico continued to prove their scores. NHAI to develop world-class wayside amenities, more than 600 locations in a major move to improve commuters' experience on national highway for both the passengers and truckers. The National Highway Authority of India will develop world-class wayside amenities at more than 600 locations across 22 states in the next 5 years. Out of this, 130 are targeted for development of 2021-22. NHAI has already invited bids to develop 120 such wayside amenities. As per plan, wayside amenities will be developed every 30 to 50 kilometers along the current and upcoming highways and expressways. PM Modi visit to Bangladesh, report by Foreign Secretary. Foreign Secretary Shringla. The visit of Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Bangladesh starting on 26 March will be of very special significance in reinforcing the comprehensive strategic partnership between the two countries. The briefing the media ahead of the official state visit of Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Bangladesh, Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringla said that the Prime Minister's first visit to a foreign country after the COVID-19 pandemic signifies the importance of India attached to its tie with Bangladesh. Gram Ujala program launched in Varanasi. The Union Minister of State for Power and New and Renewable Energy, R.K. Singh, launched the Gram Ujala program in Varanasi of Uttar Pradesh. Under this program, Convergence Energy Service Limited, CESL, a wholly owned subsidiary of Energy Efficient Service Limited, will distribute high-quality LED bulbs at an affordable cost in rural areas. Under the scheme, 1 crore 50 lakh LED bulbs will be distributed in phase 1, resulting in energy saving of 20-25 million kilowatt per year and CO2 reduction of 1.65 million ton CO2 per year. Asia's largest tulip garden in Kashmir opened. In the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, Asia's largest tulip garden in Srinagar is scheduled to be open for the general public and tourists. The tulip garden in Srinagar is a spectrum of colors featuring lakhs of tulips which have blossomed in the lap of Jabarwan Hills along the bank of world famous Dal Lake in Srinagar city. Prime Minister Narendra Modi in his tweet has urged the people to visit Jammu and Kashmir and enjoy the scenic tulip garden festival in Srinagar, where 15 lakh flowers of more than 64 varieties are in the full bloom nowadays. CJI Justice recommends Union Government to appoint Justice N.V. Ramana as the next Chief Justice of India. Chief Minister of India Justice S.A. Bobde has recommended Union Government to appoint the senior most Supreme Court Judge Justice N.V. Ramana as the next Chief Justice of India. Chief Justice Bobde is set to retire on 23rd April. Justice Bobde was sworn in as the 47th Chief Justice of India in November 2019. Traditionally, the sitting of Chief Justice writes a recommendation for his likely successor. CAT member in Magasese Award. Recipient offers plea 7th in 8 year. There has been yet another recusal from Magasese Award recipient India's Forest Service officer Sanjeev Chaturvedi's petition by the member of the bench of Central Administrative Tribunal, making it the 7th such instance since 2013. The observations came while hearing alleging irregularities in the lateral entry of joint secretaries in the center. The member rescued himself, citing that his relative counsels might have appeared for respondents in the matter and he might have appeared with them for those respondents. Russia launches 38 satellites for 18 countries into orbit. On March 22, 2021, Russian space agency Roscosmos successfully launched 38 foreign satellites into orbit. On board Soyuz 2.1, a carrier rocket from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. The rocket will place in the orbit 38 satellites and it belongs to 18 countries including South Korea, Japan, Canada, Saudi Arabia, Germany, Italy, and Brazil. Among them is the Challenge 1, the first satellite made completely in Tunisia, which was created by the Telnet Telecommunication Group. Virat Kohli moves to fourth position, Rohit Sharma to 14th. ICC T20 player rankings. India captain Virat Kohli and vice captain Rohit Sharma are among the Indian batsmen to progress in the ICC men's T20 player ranking after clinching the home series against England for 3-2 in Ahmedabad. Kohli has moved up one place to fourth position and he is the highest ranked from India ahead of KL Rahul. Rohit moved up three places to 14th in the ICC men's T20 player rankings. While Yadav rose from bottom to 66th position, Pant has moved up 11 places to 69th in the ranking. That's all for today's current affair bulletins. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.